One, two, three. What's happening, folks? I'm Andy, and this is Nail Guitar, the channel where I teach you to play songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. I try and compress as much as the song all into this tiny little morsel of a single guitar as I can so that you can make it sound like the song rather than just the guitar parts. As always, I got a free PDF for you to view on your device or to print out if you're feeling old school. It is there to help you. I'll be making reference to it through the lesson. And it's really nifty. Go and grab it now via the first comment or the description down below. What do we got? We got a capo on the second fret so that we don't have to do any super uber horrible bar chord extra stretches of doom. So what are our chords that we've got happening here? Well, it's the rock and roll treatment. Like many songs that I've been teaching recently seem to have this rock and roll vibe. What we call six chords and five chords. So five chord most people know as a power chord. But underlying that, if you want to kind of play this as a strumming chord, we have, or a strumming song should I say. We got E, A, and we got B that I like to play rather than making you do a bar chord. You can if you want, but I like to make it sing with magnificent open string goodness, letting the open B string and E string ring out underneath. Because that's what acoustic guitar is all about in my books. So there's those three chords of glory. It is E, A, and B. If you've got those happening, then we're in a good place to start. So, intro, B, A, E. Now what is specifically happening inside that little riffy action that we've got there? So what's going on in that little riffy thing? It's the same treatment for each chord, so if I just take that E chord there. So I'd be going from the, what we consider our virtual second fret to our virtual fourth fret. It would be 2-2-4-2-2-4. And you can keep that strumming after, or you can just let that ring out, it's up to you. Same for the A. For the B chord, little stretch here. You got to stretch your fourth finger up there. If you can't do it, just keep it as a straight old power chord there. Because it is the least frequent chord in the song anyway. So, what do we have there to begin the song? We had B, A, E. So these stop chords, this is the start of our verse that we've got here. The very first time, they are short cutoff chords. And typically it gets opened up in that fourth bar. Now, there is another way that you can do that as well, and there is variations. It's only in the first time that those cutoffs happen. The rest of the time, It is just letting it ring. And really picks up there, so you can throw your strumming in. So another variation that you can throw into that is doing a cutoff just on the fourth bar. Which creates a nice little lead up to move into our next section. So that gives you a few little variations that you can do there. So our first four bars of the verse that we've just done are E. We then move on to A, but I'll play it all the way through to give you some context. And we'll do this slow. So, one, two, three, da 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 da, and an E, 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 E. Then we're up to A, back to E, B, A, B, E. That again. E, 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 B, A, B, E. Now, if you wanted to, I was saying before, you can make this just a jangly song without all the. So, by all means. A, back to E. B, B, B. A, B, B, back to E. And you could treat that B as a B7. Fits the rock and roll vibe very nicely. Second fret, first, second, open, second. Bam, bam, bam. B7 back to E. From there, we're into our next verse, verse 2. Da 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 A, E, and a E, 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 then F to A. Another verse. E, 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 then up to A. A, A, back to E. B, A, B, E. Now you may notice there's a little upbeat change on that A chord. Generally we're starting on the first beat, but for the A, sneaks in a little early. So B, A on the upbeat. Our solo section is A, E, A, B. There you go, the rest of the form is there on the song guide for you. If you haven't grabbed it already, be sure to grab it right now. Great for reference, great for rehearsing the song and not having to store everything in your head. That's hard work. It's not too hard when you're first picking up the guitar and you've only got one or two songs happening, but as you get more and more songs, they float away out of your ear and you don't want that. You want to make your life as easy as possible. So that is why I've created the song guide for you. Grab that. My name's Andy. Be sure to subscribe for more lessons here on the channel. It is all about learning to play songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. I always keep to the essentials, keeping away from all the fluff and the unnecessary details so that you can get playing songs sooner. If you would like to get playing lots of songs sooner, the best way to do that is with the Easy Songs cheat sheet that I've got available for you. It is a super, super cool resource. And it is available for you. I'll tell you about it now. Save countless hours searching for easy songs to learn and download my Easy Songs cheat sheet. Click the link in the description now to get it absolutely free.